Hello children, hope you all are fine. This is grade 3 science class. Now today let us do the next subtopic from block 17. We need air. The next subtopic, air occupies space. So in the previous class we have learned that air is everywhere. So how we have concluded, how we have learned that air is everywhere? By taking a small polythene bag, we have concluded that the bag is filled up with the air. So in that way we have concluded that air is everywhere. And also, are you able to breathe in all the rooms present at your home, children? Yes, we are able to breathe in all the rooms. So even in the garden, even in the kitchen, even in the bedroom, and even in the balcony. So wherever in you go at your home, you can breathe. That means by this also we can say that air is everywhere. So we have learned that air is everywhere. Now, and also we learned air is having mass and air is occupying some of the space. So how it is occupying some of the space? When we blow the balloon, it occupies the space in the balloon. When we take a container like a bottle, it occupies the space of the container. So in that way, so what is present inside the bottle? Air is present. So how we can say that air is present inside the bottle? By a small activity, how it is occupying space, how the air is occupying space in this bottle, let us learn by an activity, children. Children, here is a bowl of water and you can see the container. Empty container will have air inside it. So now I am taking the empty container. Now I am going to put it straight in the bowl of water. So what you are going to observe? So what is your prediction, children? Will the water enters into the bottle? So that you may think that the water may enter into the bottle. But when I keep it straight, we can see that the water does not enter into the bottle. But when Now what I'll do, I'm going to tilt it. Can you see the bubbles there? Yes. So you can observe that the bubbles coming out. Now you can see the bottle will have water in the container. Now water entered into the bottle. Now what we have seen, the bubbles came out from the bottle when we have tilted the bottle. But when we kept it straight, we didn't see any bubbles coming out. But when we have tilted, we can see that the bubbles came out. So that means the air inside the bottle, it came out in the form of bubbles. And now the water took the space in the container. So by this we can say that the air is occupying the space in the container, in the empty containers. So by this we can conclude that air is occupying space, children. So children, you have observed the activity. So what we have done, first we have taken a jar and we have filled up with water. Then we have inverted the bottle in straight position. We have put the bottle in inverted position in a straight way. So we didn't put it in a sideways, we have kept it in a straight way. So what happened? What did you have guessed before when we are doing the activity? What did you predict there? So you have thought that the water will enter into the bottle. But did the water enter there? No. Then what we have done? The next thing, after 2 minutes, we have tilted the bottle. So when we have tilted the bottle, what happened? Will the water enter into the bottle? So what is your prediction? So you have thought that the water will enter into the bottle. So water entered, but we have seen bubbles coming out. So these bubbles indicate that air is present inside the bottle. So that air is coming out when you are tilting the bottle in the jar. So the bottle, the contained air, it came out and the water started entering in. So till now, here, The air is present inside, so the air doesn't allow the water to enter into the bottle. But when you have tilted the bottle, what happened? The air present inside the bottle, it came out and the water is occupying the space in the container. So, by this we can conclude that air is occupying space in the container. So, by this bubbles, we can indicate that the bubbles in the indicates that air is present inside the bottle. Children, does water is having air inside it? Yes. How we can say? Because the living things need air to breathe. So there are some of the living things which lives in water, like fishes, crabs, starfishes, and even plants. There are some of the animals which lives in water. So even the water also contains air that help the living things which lives in water, that helps them to survive. So by this we can say that even water also contains air. Okay children, now open your readers. Children, open your reader, page number 107. Here air takes up space. When we blow into a balloon, air takes up the space inside the balloon, making it bigger. When we blow into a balloon, air takes up the space inside the balloon, making it bigger. Underline blow and space. So you're going to write this as keywords. So what happens, children, when we blow the balloon, air takes up the space inside the balloon, then balloon becomes bigger. And we can also see the empty containers, the empty bottles will have air inside it. So here, air takes up space. Write these two words as keywords in your classwork. Now, take out practice questions, children. Today you are going to complete third and fourth. Page number 110. Third and fourth you are going to complete. Look at the picture. What does it tell you about air? So you are going to draw this figure also in your classwork. Look at the picture. What does it tell you about air? What it tells us? When you are filling the air inside the ball, it takes up the space. The air inside the ball takes up space and the ball becomes bigger. So it tells us, the figure tells us, the picture tells us, the air, when we fill the air inside the ball, the air takes up space, air occupies space inside the ball and makes it bigger. So this answer you are going to write. We keep biscuits in an airtight jar to store it for a long time. What is an airtight jar? So we keep biscuits in an airtight jar to store it for a long time. So what is an airtight jar? Airtight jar is nothing but it doesn't allow the air to pass inside it. So when the air doesn't pass inside the jar, we can keep the biscuits, we can store it for a long time. So what is an airtight jar, children? Airtight jar is a jar which doesn't allow the air to pass inside into the jar. So that you are going to write it as answer. Now see the workbook. Take out your workbook. Page number 6 in volume 3. Today, write today's date. S2. Air occupies space. So you are going to complete the table. You have to listen the activity which I have shown. See the activity and you are going to draw the activity which I have shown here. You can draw tilted one also, tilted jar also, you can draw it here. And you are going to write what will happen when you put the bottle into the water. So did the water enter before? So if you are going to draw the two jars, you have to explain two. Water doesn't enter in the first when we kept it straight. But when we tilted the bottle, we can see the water entered into the bottle. What did you see when you put the bottle into the water?
So this one you are going to write it as prediction, and this what did you observe in the activity. So water does not enter the bottle in the first case when we kept it straight. So when we tilted the bottle, the water entered. Why did it happen? When we put the bottle straight into the bowl of water, the water does not enter the bottle. So why did it happen? Because the air present inside it, the air came out in the form of bubbles, then water entered into the bottle. See the second question. What did you learn about air from this experiment? So air takes up space or place inside the bottle, that is why it does not allow water to enter. So it takes up space and place inside the bottle, that's why it doesn't allow the water to enter. See the third one. What do you think will happen if we press this balloon? So the balloon will change the shape because there is air inside it. So it changes the shape because the air is inside the balloon. So in this way you are going to write. So this one you are going to observe the activity and you are going to write it, children, because I am showing a child written book. So you are going to write what did you have observed and your predicted and prediction and observation and what did you learn from that. So you are going to complete this. Okay, children.